Hello.
All right, and with that, we will give it over to our casters. We've got Mott and Mott Packs once more.
Guys, we are here with our Game 3 match between Escape and OG, our last match of the day. Of course, you guys just heard all the panel's predictions. Trent, what do you have for this game based on the draft?
Well, we have the added advantage of checking out some lanes.
Because
Jerex and Yapsor are just going to throw out some harass. Jerex came in with the smoke, but... that gets run into by Yapsor. I think he saw Yapsor walk over the ward and then not have it. So, yeah, and it's being pinged out now. So,
yeah.
They're aware this ward is here. So, nice little pickup for the side of OG. But we'll take a look at these lanes because it's, well, I guess what you'd kind of expect, right? It's going to be maybe the core Spearbreaker not necessarily expected. I think he'll probably be getting a lot of love with Jerex, maybe rotating down there, unless Jerex is going to be super greedy like his Bloodseeker game and spend more time in the jungle. We used to see a lot of this, like, Enchantress Slardar sort of a dual off lane and. Might see the same thing with Enchantress Spearbreaker. Man, that is a lot of pinging from Koikwa. He's not happy about that.
That was some serious pinging.
Lol.
What's happening?
Wow, Sinner, thank you, dude.
Escape's just having a good time, man. That's what you can tell from this. At least I
I'm going with OG.
Okay.
I think S4 is going to go like totally ham the Spearbreaker. Get it? Because he's a cow, ham.
I get it.
See what I did there?
Wait, all right.
I know,
you know,
it's a pig. It doesn't make any sense.
It doesn't.
Great.
I was like, that's
it's
not
extra
right.
Good.
But I was trying to help you out there, man. But
that makes it even better.
Okay. We'll just leave it that way. Yeah, that's fine.
So yeah, he'll run down the Ember. He'll run down the Weaver. He'll run down the Zeus. Let's go.
I think I'm with you in OG, but like Purge, I'm not confident about my prediction, honestly. This is an interesting matchup. A lot of really cool heroes, a lot of different things you can get done. The way that the lanes are shaping up, especially, we already talked about. Purge
can we
expressing
get like
disdain
a,
for
like
fly
a distant move from the couch? Like, I can hear them when they laugh. Can they all just move?
There's only one person there. It's Andrew right now.
Slax is gone. He doesn't actually care
Slax
about the
game. Slax is gone, and he, I think, went to take a break or something.
They just
I'm
laugh
sure.
a couple times to be a soundboard, and then they're just, you know, they don't care.
Oh, they're not in it. Did you hear that? Yeah, that was great, wasn't it?
That was a haha by
All right, into the game we go. 54 seconds in. We'll look at the mid matchup first and foremost. Koikwa with the 4-man shield, so too has the Magnus. Oh, top lane, there's a pincer maneuver
so
coming in. Flies pretty low, Jerex. He's got that Satyr. He's going to throw the shockwave. It'll hit Kezu. Kezu's still getting kited. Flies like, please, I just want to bring you down. Meanwhile, on the other side, you can see the Enchantress chasing after Yapsor. Will they get either of these?
Yes.
One more Shockwave is on cooldown for 5 seconds. Will they get Kezu? It looks like no. The Spectral Dagger will go first to slow him down. The Gale will hit, and yes, they will pick him up. And then Jerex does get the kill on the other side for Yapsor. So that is 2 quick kills. No-Tail is a bit far out of lane, but that's fine.
And that's what great prioritization by Jerex, too. Not to just come over and help with the Beastmaster kill.
He's still going, although Yapsor will clean up the Satyr and get 83 gold out of it. Still, there's a lot of damage. Yapsor doesn't have
he
any regen.
This, though.
He really wants to, I think, D-Ward 2. He has the sentry ready to go, and Jerex is just harassing the hell out of Yapsor. He has to sit behind the tower. He might have to just go home or deny himself at this point.
Yeah, he's going to know this ward is here, which is a little bit of a downside, but it's fine. Obviously, OG have already gotten a ton of this.
That is a lot of space created, a lot of work done for Jerex. Quick will pick himself up an Invis rune. Mid matchup, very even. Why? Clarity up.
Yeah, he has the clarity to D ward this because he doesn't want to waste a sentry, I think, because he knows there's a ward up there anyway.
Yeah. Drop the sentry here. He has a lightning bolt back up and ready to go now if he wants to use it to D ward. Anyways. This is a pretty good start for OG, all things considered. Down in the safe lane for Escape, S4, the solo offlane Spirit Breaker, is trying to harass out Cinderin, who throws up the Poison Touch. S4 only getting about 5 last hits to the 6 of the Beastmaster currently. Everything pretty much going evenly with the exception of that top lane.
Hey, you just be careful. Well, getting mad hurt from this Shadow Wave. Obviously, Spearbreaker, him and Ogre set up with that ridiculous amount of armor. He's already hanging out with 6, 7, of course, if he just gets near the tower, too. He needs to tank up a little bit here, so he'll do well against the heavy physical damage of a Weaver Dazzled Lane, but he's not too careful. The spam and then a quick Shikuchi over from Eric could spell demise for him.
Yeah.
At least they have no way to stop a charge, though, for his escapes if it gets a little bit too low.
I mean, and S4 only has 1 Tango left as well, whereas Kezu on the other side of the map has 3 Tangos, so they have a bit more regen going in that Radiant offlane. So S4 does have to be wary, like you mentioned, but we'll keep an eye on him down in that bottom lane. For now, Ana and Quakefa two pretty important heroes. And Ana has started stepping up his game. I think a lot of that has to do with him skilling up Shockwave and now it being at level 3.
Yeah, mag versus enemy melee mid. Always going to be a fun time.
Yeah.
Anyway, you can harass around with the empower.
Flame Guard will be annoying for Ana, but other than that, should be okay for the most part. Good produce. Gaps are rotating in. Lightning Bolt's available. Level 2 now, but no, they really want this 4-minute rune, and Kezu's going to get there first. In fact, Ana's gonna skewer Eddie. Well, I think
he got it.
I don't know if it's gonna be worth it at this point. If he dies, he's really low. The axes will come out so low. He needs at least a couple more right clicks. Ana looking to turn around. He pops the bottle. Gets some mana regen going his way, as well as HP. Kezu trying to TP out. The Centaur Conqueror stomp is there in time from Jerax. And Kezu will almost certainly fall.
What a player.
I cannot believe he actually just got that bounty rune. Tower is under
attack. Yo. Everyone, you know, kind of question up maybe on the Ana. So Mr. Ana here from OG, everyone's like, is he as good as they say? You know, he's being brought into the squad. That's probably one of the bigger plays I've seen him make. It's in the early game.
For sure. I thought he was going to screw up to the high ground there and say, I can't get this, but shows what I know. Played.
Well, JX has rotated in very deep here too. Cleaning up some of these camps that I'm sure Ember wouldn't mind being left alone, or possibly even the Beastmaster coming over the Iron Talon. As that top lane is just kind of scary for Kezu. Level 3, he'll go up. He's got a little bit of a stack here. Probably made by Jerax to get himself a secondary creep.
Try to take it down with the level 2 boar, level 1 axes, and an Iron Talon. Down bottom, though. S4 taking plenty of damage. He gets the bash and the arrow, the charge through. He gets the kill! The RNG is with him, S4. And they might find a second. They'll get the root up onto center, and he's getting chased down. And with 15 HP, a TP is almost certainly not going to help him here. Jerax will find the second kill. What a turn of events for S4 in this offlane.
5-0. All while a Spectre is just farming away up top. Has himself that kill, already up into the ring of health. Going to Vanguard again, we talk about the physical damage from Dazzle and the Weaver. Helped to shut that down. Vanguard great up against Beastmaster and all his creeps, as well as the Necros. Not gonna help too much against Zeus and Ember necessarily in terms of like the early magic damage focus that those two have, but
right.
It's a pretty solid Vanguard game, especially when it's like so free, like just no problems in his lane right now.
Yeah, this is great root farm for a Spectre to have. Mid lane, looks like there's gonna be
Harpy canceled.
Harass. Jerax is gonna actually avoid the Lightning Bolt. It will get hit onto the Dark Troll Summoner, unfortunately. Sacrifice. No backup. Ana does have level 6, so he has reverse polarity ready to go. He has his treads up as well. And he's going to start getting involved in these fights. Flies very low top lane. Level 5 standing at about 200 HP. You can see Koikva's rotated up as well.
The question is, to find Syndrin. And looks like he's probably just dead here.
No grave. He's only
now,
level 3.
And S4 can choose who they kill too, right? Because like they're already bottom.
They're haunting in. They want to go for it. He wanted to get out of a bad position as Koikva rotated up. They already brought down Fly. And actually, No Tail just goes mid. Oh, his salve gets canceled. The boar poison, I think, came from across the map, I'm pretty sure. Somehow. Right click coming in from Kezu.
Yeah. Doesn't
Ana destroy. Actually got the shockwave. They should be able to get this kill if he can get this. He's RP ready to go. Shockwave will do the job. Oh my god, he lives with like 20 HP, and now Ana has gone too far. Cinder can't do this on his own. He will just TP out, and Ana will stay safe. Era, Gucci, not there in time.
That's a big rotation for him too. TP'd from bottom, fearing that there might have been something coming from the Spirit Breaker. He was quite correct, as he was indeed being charged. So, the bottom tower does go down. That's pretty nice considering, obviously it's 6-1 in terms of kills, but they have taken the first objective here.
They needed something like that for escape to go their way. They do have the top net worth hero again, Koikva. He's done this before. He's currently sitting on Boots of Travel if he wants to buy them at about 4 gold. He has it now after getting that Plague Ward.
Yeah, that's
Era
pretty
getting
crazy.
Charged. Says he doesn't have mana for time lapse. Era in trouble. No mana for Shikuchi either. The ultimate not needed. S4 helps Ana bring him down with a shockwave.
And
there's the bash again. But Ana now will just skewer out, realizing they might have dove the tower too far. Lightning Bolt will not connect, and both of the heroes split up. S4 heads to the north. Ana heads towards that top rune spot, but here comes Koikva to cut off the path to the tree. RP comes in, only onto 2, looks like it might have been 3. Unfortunately, not enough damage between just himself to be able to get any of those kills.
Yeah, possibly, like, if they turn around there, maybe they just get the kill on the Kezu, and they could even possibly, like, escape back through, but they have no idea where the Ember is coming from.
Uh-oh.
Exactly.
Speaking
he goes right back top.
Yeah, he really wants Fly. He does get slowed up. He gets up the Slight of Fissuri chain, but Fly, I do not think that TP will be safe enough. S4 takes the Lightning Bolt from Yapzor. The charge is not complete. They jump in with another Fire Remnant, and Koikpa finds himself a double kill after just getting his Boots of Travels up to 600 gold.
Oh, Quick was turning this one around.
He really is. Game looked really one-sided for the first, like, 5 minutes or so.
That's one thing about Spectre, and one reason we don't see it too often. It's just, like, the cooldown on Haunt is actually absurd, and it doesn't even get that much better. Like, 2 minutes at fully leveled, and for now it's 140 seconds.
Right.
The charge on the Cinderin, probably just scouting, I think.
Yeah, I think they're probably going to cancel that one. This will make some space for no-tail down bottom. Actually, a significant amount of tower damage being dealt just by the siege creep, as well as the creeps in general.
Radiant structures are
here we go from here. We're going to charge in again. Cinderin will stay back again.
Koikpa now.
Oh, Koikpa seems to be everywhere. I'm going to use the empower and try to keep S4 dealing some damage, but he's just, it's too much for him to deal with on his own.
I didn't even get that much damage here either.
No, they really didn't. You take the tier 1 tower bottom while that is happening, though, but Koikpa on the hunt for Ana, slowed him down with the poison touch. He'll be able to get closer to his side of the river and stay alive as they start pressuring the tier 1 tower mid themselves.
Yeah, this tower is very low. Aaron's getting a lot of space up the top lane. He'll be into his treads shortly.
No-tail
is still pretty much unkillable, at least for now. This unless he, like, dives 5 heroes or something.
Possibility. Going for Cinderin currently. Skewer, they have Shockwave, it'll hit. Grave should be available, and it is. They'll try to turn this around. No mana for RPG. He has this taken now. He'll get it onto two. He might be able to bring down Cinderin. Yes, he will, but Koikpa going to work on Ana. On the other side, Aerith going to toe-to-toe with No-Tail. No-Tail's going to TP out. Ana will be the sacrificial lamb this time around. Koikpa was not there in time to be able to use the Searing Chains.
He knew he was so dead, he didn't even go for the magic wand. Just too many heroes. Great responses again here from the Radiant side.
Yeah, they're moving really well together. There's not really been many Primal Roars. Kezu's kind of been off farming, but, you know, Koikpa has been the one that's helping his squad out. He's just all over the place, and that's with Fire Remnant, with Boots of Travel, got great mobility.
Yeah, we're having these, like, weird fights too, where, like, Enchantress and Spearbreaker aren't there. And these, like, early game engagements and clashes where you're expecting that to be there. Like, this aggression from the creeps when they're the most powerful up against your enemies. The Spearbreaker too, who had some nice early levels. But now it's just S4 up to level 7, still holding on to his dust, he's got treads. And you're in that kind of awkward point of Spearbreaker where, like, your next item, it's kind of variable. Like, Echo Saver's been very popular lately. Makes sense on the hero, obviously, you get a second chance at a bash. Used to be we'd often just see a straight BKB out of the position for Spearbreaker, so how valuable it is on the hero. Could grab an urn, but
yeah, I was thinking
there's already one on Jerax.
Yeah, they could go for two, but yeah, I think you're right. I'm probably going to forego that. There's a lot of options for him too. He's got 1,000 gold, so it's not like he's, you know, yeah, he's had a couple of bad team fights or he's died a couple of times, but he'll be able to get that next item pretty quickly. The Beastmaster has just gotten his Tranquil, so his Necro is not going to be completed anytime soon, unless there's something on the courier that I don't believe there is. So it's going to be a while before we have that Necro 3 up for.
Oh, look at them dewarding mid though. They're going to smoke up with Roar. Just to ensure that this isn't spotted by the Dire.
This is the perfect time for it.
How does Koikpa just get this free tower top?
I don't know if it's free. The charge is going to come through. The Haunt's there. They need the RP. They don't have it. Doesn't even matter. It's not required. He's dead without it. 40 seconds on the sideline. That is a gigantic kill because it's dominating spree. And the Magnus will pick it up. Not only that, but the Spectre was involved as well. Here
all
we
right,
go,
baited.
Though. The smoke. They might know. Look at Fly in No-Tail's position. And they see Kezu walk out. The smoke is done for him. They'll use the Spectral Dagger. More TP's coming through. They do have RP ready to go. Mana is about halfway for Ana. Kezu's already backing up the Axor. Maybe staying too long. The charge is up and ready to go. Cinderin's been caught by Jerax in the backside. Zusol will come through. No Haunt was just used. They actually missed the Venomous Gale. He'll try to TP up. They need a bash. They need a bash. They need a bash. It's the Skewer that'll do it instead. That's what's required. Three dead on the side of Escape, including the kill they got top lane with Koikpa. What's that?
The moving bash.
I mean,
counts. Yeah. The same thing.
Same thing.
Big run back for them. A lot of gold going to the Venno and the Magnus. With now Blink 700 gold. We'll see if he just opts into, like, the Forest Staff style.
the Arise build.
Yeah, might feel like he needs more damage. I know we've seen quite a few people going for this like new kind of, I don't know, I've heard it dubbed the Weehaw build.
Ooh, Shard Toss actually gets disjointed with that Fireman. Koifa is going to find another one to the low ground, making them sweat, juking and jiving. S4 will take the swarm. Is his model screwed up for you too, or is that just me?
Yeah, if you bash, I think it's when you run into people on stairs, it gets stuck. It's like that for all the players too. Then he's hard to click.
Swimming in the ground, I like it.
It's like Jug too, if he gets bashful spinning.
Interesting. Ana still has RP, mind you. He thought about it for a second. He almost pulled the trigger. He blinked and looking for Yapsor. Now he'll have to break off pursuit.
Did he forget Skewer's
on
cooldown?
RP on it too. Skewer, he won't be able to get on the other side without dying first, but they do get a nice RP. They get a bash on Cinderin. No, he gets to the Greyfall first. It was close though. S4 was trying to get that ulti. It's a double kill for Cinderin. Meanwhile, Quick was going to work on Fly. He finds himself a kill. 3 down. All the meanwhile, No-Tail is farming bottom. Jirax is hightailing it out of mid. Era though still wants that kill, but unfortunately Drax is too fast and too far gone.
Man, just seconds off the Skewer cooldown. I'm not sure, like maybe he just really wanted the RP as you said and didn't quite find it. But if you don't have the Skewer, obviously it's a little bit of a riskier play. Don't have that instant escape. Punished heavily, ends up losing 3 heroes. Tower goes down. Koifa again, just getting more and more kills. Now well on his way to the Battle Fury.
I mean, he's 5-1-2. That one death obviously sets him back a little bit, but excellent performance from Koifa so far in this game.
And we assume this is going to be the Radiance Spectre. One great thing about Vanguard, they didn't really have anyone who's good at taking the Ancients on their team, but now with the combination of Power and Vanguard, that will allow No-Tail to do so.
Here we go.
Taking a lot of magic damage.
Fight breaking out, they'll get Cinderin first before he can get his Grave off. Yapsor out of mana, and they'll jump in with Ana and Fly here. Venomous Gale not needed, he has it ready to go. 2 dead. Weaver will take down Jirax. Not sure if that was from the Swarm or what.
Might have been an urn?
Yeah, it could have been, yeah. He does have one.
Yeah, he was at an urn charge just for himself.
Still a 2-for-1, though. Again, and another positive fight going the way of OG. Koifa wasn't there, obviously, a big factor into that one, as he's trying to man up against S4, who will just TP away smartly. All right, Trent. Where do we go from here?
Gold from the Battle Fury.
Yeah, he's actually super close. He's going to remnant out, too. He was getting charged again. He's going to have it pretty early on here. He can start split pushing with that, keep the quick waves pushed out. They're already pushing top lane with Era here as well as Kezu. Again, before he even gets his book. Book 1 coming out soon. He has the Staff of Wizardry and Belt of Strength.
So No-Tail went back for the Yasha. So it'll be more of a Manta-focused build. When we have seen Spectre lately, it has generally been still the Radiance. Like Bone 7, I believe, picked up a couple of games, went for that build. But just a lot of early fights coming, a lot of pressure. The Radiance has a lot of value against like Necro Books as well as just the Weaver, general squishier heroes. Like getting on top of someone like Cinderin can be devastating, but it's the same thing can happen. Like you don't get the mischance obviously in all the summons and whatnot now, but and same thing with mischance on the Weaver, but you can still blow up a Dazzle with Manta Defusal. If you just hop on top, like it's sometimes you can't even get the Grave off in time. So still gonna get a lot of the same effect and you scale. I guess you scale better with the Radiance obviously, but you'll fight a lot better really with the Manta Defusal.
Certainly will. Jirax is going to avoid the swarm in the top lane. He's able to back out and get behind his tier 2 tower while the rest of his team is farming mid. But everyone from Escape has rotated top. There's the book 1, so pushing is going to get better. They also get Yapsor a veil, another early veil for Yapsor. Yeah, in the Kung Fu game. They'll take the tier 2 tower for Escape. No problems there.
Yeah, Dire and I'm going to fight it, just pressuring mid instead. It looks like they won't be back in time. They will throw the Glyph. First TP comes from the Dazzle. I think Shanna has this one.
Shadowblade done for the Spirit Breaker, by the way. The tower will be denied, Plague Wards.
Ooh,
close.
Nice.
The Siege Creep helped out a lot there.
They're wrapping from behind. Dire don't have vision this right now.
The Plague Wards will spot out Kezu and OG are staying around. Ana looks like he wants to go, but they've spotted him already.
Oh, charge on the quick button in mid lane. Oh, gets him in time.
They'll find him here, and looks like he might be in trouble. He remnants out and gets away, though. Low on the other side. No fight breaking out just yet. Then with the swarm, Era walks up to the high ground. The rest of the team coming in for OG. Be careful for escaping their positioning.
That was getting a little dicey with the Remnant timers, in fact.
Oh, he's still might be in trouble. He's going to Remnant through. He's on the high ground. He's Remnant again. No Tail still coming after him. The Spectral Dagger. Oh. It's not going to be there in time. Honest going to have to skewer. I think he's in trouble here. He will skewer. He doesn't make it across the river, but his team is there to back him up with Jirax on the high ground.
And, yeah, this is the build that I was going to mention, though. This, like, I've heard it dubbed the Weehaw Magnus. I'm not sure if he actually pioneered it, but that's what everyone's telling me. So it's kind of just like Echo Saver style. With the Empower, you max it out. Instead of, like, the 2 points in Skewer, you just go one, full Empower, Echo Saver, double damage inside the RP. It's pretty insane. Kind of like the old Mask of Madness build. It's quick discharge once again here, but all the way back home.
He's really making him work for this. Just pushing out top. And they come back, they get the charge off, and think, okay, maybe we can get him here. He gets out in time. So Koifa continues just to be a nuisance for OG to deal with. Not the top of the net worth anymore. That honor goes to No Tail for now, as I think he's just purchased up his full Manta style. And with Empower, this is going to make his life a lot easier to farm, too. He's already had it for a little while.
Yeah, with all these charges coming on the Koifa, too, he's just been slowed down. Like, that exponential growth has suddenly halted. The Shadow Blade, as you pointed out, is just going to continue doing so. Now you need, like, Observer and Sentry combinations to make sure you're totally safe. So he'll just have to be very diligent about his Remnants, making sure that he always has an escape plan, because he can never count on when he's being charged. Jirax, the number one thing you don't want to see is Enchantress, because they veil Zeus.
Yeah, that's probably not fun. Fly is already like, I'm out of here, and he will escape.
Get this man some raindrops. Not that it'll probably save you, honestly.
I don't know if that would have done anything there, unfortunately, for him.
I don't think so.
It's better to lose him, though, than a core, and he does fall the support. Enchantress, Jirax is having a very good game.
I think they'd love to get a core picked off here inside of Escape so they can head into the Roche Pit.
Tail walking in. Manta style still available. Roar doesn't go. Actually gets the Manta off in time. Finally, we'll use it after the Manta illusions are gone forward. Here comes Zara, gets charged through as this four runs in. They really want this kill onto Kezu, and he will get brought down. RP onto Ember so that he can't get out. Now they even use the ultimate coming up for the Venomancer. Era's still hunting, looking for another pickoff. They have Jirax. They get the Nature's Attendance off. The Urn Charge from Ana will not bring him down, but he is very low. So one for nothing exchange. They do root the Spirit Breaker so he can't chase any further. Koifa is still fighting fit, even with that Poison Nova on him. It is, however, a one-for-nothing exchange.
After all that, everything but Haunt thrown out. Yeah, the Dire don't have quite the same potential in terms of roaching. We saw that pretty ridiculous roach by Arteezy on his Venno. Of course, that was position
so
one.
Long.
It really did. It was a hell of a lot of warts, though.
There must have
friends.
Been like 20 or something in there, something ridiculous, however much you can throw in there. You must have had the max.
Koifa is going to find Jirax up top, but I'm going to bother opting for it here as he's pretty close to the dark side base. You need quite a bit of flame to bring him on down. Nope.
Alright, No-Tail is taking a pretty big stack here for his Ancients, which is huge. This is going to get him up to about 1500. You already talked about Manta Defusal. Do you think that's what he's going to buy next? Blade for the Spectre?
Yeah, unless there's something that we're just not thinking of in terms of the escape lineup. I mean,
I don't think so.
Yeah, it's just such a core item on this hero. It's so good for your chase potential. Nice in general. We
can't
talked, I think Andrew brought it up, just the Lincoln Spear on the Weaver and how that interacts with Spirit Breaker, where it's like it kind of goes both ways, where it's like, yeah, he can pop it across the map, but
right.
He also just can't be charged across the map anymore, like Broodmother and stuff like that, who just is notorious for just being run down. Rickies, bounty hunters, people who rely on this general invisibility and evasiveness. So that is one part, but it's kind of frustrating when, like, if you're like smoking into them and you're like near a ward or something and you just pop the Lincolns and someone like blink stuns them, but he doesn't really have allies that do that, right? There's no one else that, like, you're not from a distance popping Lincolns for a lion to blink hex or something.
Mm-hmm.
But I don't think it's too bad this game for the Weaver.
That's a good point.
Because yeah. Like RP and stuff goes through anyway, so I don't know.
It's true. Weaver's gonna have a hard enough time surviving through some of these heroes, let alone the charge from Lincoln Sphere, but there's other things. No Tail, just break that smoke. Oh, he's gonna walk right into the Yapsor. Lightning Bolt won't go. They still are, I think, going to get him with the Primal Roar. He has Magic Style. This Lightning Bolt will come out so low, but they should bring him down one more right click. And in fact, Era will be the one to take the kill. So, Smoke is successful in finding the biggest target in the game for Escape thus far. He's down for 50 seconds. Provide Era almost his Lincoln Sphere. I believe it's coming pretty soon. They have the Necro, I believe, 2. for Kezu flying out now. And that's going to signal Roche for them.
Yeah, we'll see if the Dire want to fit some sort of like crazy buyback haunt. Is it worth it at this point in the game?
If they can get an RP, but I mean, are they going to go for that?
I think they're too far out already.
Yeah, they're already... It might not go that fast. They're moving over there. They're positioning themselves, but there is a great Observer Ward from the Radiant team that will scout this movement, and so they shouldn't get caught by this RP.
Yeah, they can throw in the wards, though, and like, what do you do? Like, do you just leave because there's a Venom Warden?
I don't know, but here comes S4. Ooh, the Lightning Bolt comes out just
in time.
It's only
5 seconds to haunt. They've got this.
Vector's up here in a moment. And they have to back away, but they don't want to give this up to OG. Another Shockwave will go in. Kana's going to clear out the Creep Wave first.
The Battle of the Vision over the pit, the Haunt, the Metal Wards, both teams.
This is so tense, actually.
It's so low right now.
No-Tail is going in on his own. He wanted to see how low Roche is. It's not low enough, and he's now stuck on the high
he
ground, it looks
careful.
Like. He finally will get down to the low ground. For a second, that is Spectral Dagger somehow. Didn't let him get down there, but unfortunately for them, for Escape Gaming, they can't capitalize on him going into the Roche pit. He's soloing it right now. Eric came over to the other side, goes up to the high ground, doesn't find anything. Where are the rest of Escape Gaming? They're still clearing out some creeps over back in the jungle. They'll find Jirax, the Searing Chains, but No-Tail will find himself the Aegis as well as the Roshan. Now it's time to fight. They find the charge, they'll find the ultimate. They will break down Koifa, and Yapzor is next on their list. No-Tail running amok on the other side of the fight, but it's a double kill for Jirax. Everyone else TPing home from Escape, including Sindarin, as well as Kezu. Era still waiting. He has to buy a TP scroll. His Lincoln Spear will be complete, but that's a great fight. Two kills going the way of OG.
Yep, don't even have to spend RP, don't have to spend the Poison Nova either. So they have those to push into objectives with this Aegis right away if they'd like. Very well played. I guess they didn't know, judging by the pings that came up from Era, I don't think they realized that No-Tail was just in there soloing it.
Spectral Dagger, they must not have seen it somehow, which
well,
is really surprising.
They saw him Spectral this way and Manta out of the Searing Chains.
Maybe like, yeah, he kind of faked it when he was up on the hill. Yeah. Kind of interesting that it worked out that way. He was just able to walk in there and solo it. He is, by the way, saving up a lot of gold. It looks like it might be that Radiance after all. He's got 3,000.
It does like have a lot of value this game, I suppose. See, still down with the Diffusal Blade, just how much it does, like the Haunt illusions on top of someone like a support Zeus especially, and this Dazzle just seemed kind of ridiculous.
Yeah, they're gonna get blown. Even though the Weaver is not
the Beastmaster too, honestly. Like mana is just, you know, hard to come by.
He does.
Yeah,
there's the
Diffusal.
Okay. All right. I was like, well, maybe. You know, I thought he just might be saving gold, and he was. So it is in the Radiance. He picks up the Diffusal Blade. Jirax, he's fine. That is a lot of damage though coming out from Weaver.
It's kind of crazy how that's only Blightstone and Lincoln's, eh?
Right.
Like that's no Deso or anything like that. Just a very squishy hero.
Yeah. Mech is done for the Venomancer. On top of the hood that he already has, no mech on the side of Escape.
Doesn't end up finishing the pipe mix. Pretty much. Yeah, it's decent sense. Like, he gets the pipe eventually, but I think his allies are tanking up, other than Enchantress, of course, that they don't necessarily need the pipe quite yet. It'll be good when they're sieging. For now, the mech probably adds more value.
I think so. Another Shadowblade done for Ana. It'll fly out now. And we've kind of hit this point where it's just farming for a couple minutes, maybe a kill here or there, but for the most part, we're just seeing a lot of pushing out lanes, making sure that No-Tail is farmed up.
They still look where they are. Just they've had the Aegis for so long now, like Haunt's back off cooldown, and they're still a Radiant mid and top, so the map's not that open for the Dire right now in terms of pushing. They've already taken down this tower down the bottom lane, so perhaps the ideal situation would be to pressure this down here. They already have some vision, keeping an eye on people to TP in, try and gain control of this area, deny anything from the Radiant side, but you know there's going to be some counter push, so they're already charging up top, and moving really fast right now.
They want Koifa. Oh, he's able to remnant out narrowly. They'll turn their attention. Sin's like, you actually just killed me. He literally remnanted over Cinderin and then died because of it. And they find the Beastmaster bottom with a solo kill for the Spectre.
Nice. Oh, quick fingers, man. By No-Tail.
That's huge. I cannot believe that Sin just died that way, though. Like, Koifa literally just killed him.
Yeah. I mean, the Haunt would have found him anyway.
I mean,
so.
Yeah, he would have died, likely. But,
but we'll
way.
Just blame Koifa.
Yeah.
Think. Yeah, that sounds good. And all now right. Charging in the mid lane onto Koifa. Speak of the devil, RP, I hear it.
He, I think, canceled it. Yeah. Yes, he was waiting for it at the Remnant. Is it enough to charge? Beautifully done from Ana. He actually came from the RP animation, waited for the Remnant to come in, and boom, used it perfectly. He knew exactly where that Remnant was.
This is your boy Ana, chat. Look at that guy. Showing off. You know, he's been reading some forums. He's like, they don't know me.
Era? Uh-oh. He has time lapse. I don't know if they can actually... Ana wants to skewer, but he's not going to pull that for 10 seconds. He needs the time lapse. Now he's going to get bashed, and he's dead for 57. They will trade Ana's life away.
Guys,
but look at this.
They're
tower. Here's the tower. The Poison Nova will go. It'll hit onto two. No-Tail is just going to work. Yapzor is next. He will find himself a triple. He wants the Ultra, and Kezu is not long for this world. No-Tail shreds through Escape Gaming.
Wow. No-Tail Dota.
That is the perfect time for that. I thought that was going a bit too far, but
I mean,
Aegis,
oh god, it's like you spend the ages. Haunt's about to be back online. At least everyone on the dire side's low. Good thing Koikva didn't have buyback there. There could have been a couple of support picks, but maybe No-Tail would have enough to scare him off anyway. It looks like he's playing Bristleback, just sitting with his back on the high ground.
I mean, he can kind of get away with it at this point. 4,000 gold. On top of that, he just
like,
lost
why not
stages.
Just go straight hard at this point, honestly?
Wake for the haunts and the Diffusal Blade, not enough to actually get his mana low enough for the Remnant to dissipate. Right.
It'd be interesting to see if he just goes straight for the Reaver. I mean, he's 5k gold ahead of the Ember. Like, this is where Heart is just so disgusting on your hero. I think damage is not really an issue for him.
No, it is not. He does not need any damage currently. With Empower especially, there's no way he really needs more damage.
And with the way Dispersion works, like, Heart can be so much more valuable than Butterfly, especially when they don't really have a hardcore right click and carry. Like, I guess Era will get there eventually, perhaps, but for now, it's not a big issue.
No.
Probably Solar Crest, like, after your Heart or something, if you're that worried.
Escape are gonna smoke up. They'll look to find a target in the enemy jungle. Ana has a DD, Shadowblade. They might find him first.
They have Necro 3.
You have Necro 3, but the Zeus ult, Kezu's not really there, and he's already skewered away. They can't find anybody. They're all going to be in the base. Short of them diving, the only person they can find is top lane, which is going to be S4, who just takes down the tower with one hit.
Maybe a little bit of miscommunication there. It's a pretty ambitious gank with a Weaver up front, considering there's Blink Daggers and Charges and Shadow Blades. Like, if Beastmaster's not there, there's no way they stop them, right? Because either it has to be a Roar, or they need the detection from the Necro Book anyway,
right.
So... just a little bit out of sorts, it seems, on the side of Escape.
Does feel like they are... could be rushing things here. Quakeba does have almost a Lincoln Sphere. Remember that he can do a pretty good job when it comes to the late game, but he's got to avoid getting picked off by these disables, the charge, the RPs, things like that, which is what he died to last gank.
Yeah, he's probably... at least he's getting a defensive item, but then he's still not going to have a Blink Dagger at that point. Then you're like, okay, well, then you get a Blink, and then you're still not stacking on any more damage, and then you have this Spectre to try and deal with who now has the Reaver. Good luck bringing down No-Tail. It's going to take a full five-man effort here with no one on the side of OG interfering, essentially,
really,
to kill
him. I don't think they can fight him anymore if, like, the Haunt comes through. Like, he's the full heart now. Like, it's 30 minutes, and he is full heart, Manta, Diffusal,
and with,
power.
Like, the Burst of Zeus and even just the Roar and stuff, like, if you don't bring him down during that and he's just out of the fight, you know, he daggers into some trees or something, but he's just going to come right back in.
Got Haunt ready. He's with his team.
Oh, give
that
to
give that
to the Spectre. Come on.
No.
What? Isn't this a Haunt play? I guess RP is more important.
I guess.
That's fair.
Era?
I mean, that's fine.
Blinked the wrong direction. Good guess coming out from Ana, but it was up to the north instead of down to the south where Era had gone already. We'll call it southwest.
So, yeah, they don't have scan. The Radiant do, I suppose, but I'm sure they're well aware of what the Dire are up to. As Ana reveals himself.
I guess you kind of have to, if you're escaped, you just keep splitting up the map. Because do you really want to fight head-on right now?
As Escape? No.
Yeah.
No, they definitely cannot do that. Head-on involves Spectre Haunts.
Well,
any five-man clash that they're willing to commit Haunt to is not a place where Escape want to be, I don't think.
No, I don't think so.
Aegis timer in just a moment here.
Radiant's top tower. Look at that. Quickfoot takes two hits. Now he has to Remnant out.
I wonder if they'll even give the Aegis to the Spectre. Era might spot this Roach. In fact, they see it with the Hawk.
Yeah, the Hawk will see it. They're TPing in, though. They want no tail. They have Koifa coming back. The
this
Haunt,
is it,
he's going to get out.
Five heroes.
Where is he rotated to? He's in the river. He actually
Dude,
went
gone.
To Sidorin and almost killed him, by the way. He's able to TP home and survive. Meanwhile, RP not there. He did skewer in. Ezu, throw up. Now mana is all gone for no-tail. Not that it matters. He's still super healthy. Will bring down Gapshore as well as Kezu. And it's S4 that gets the double kill. No-tail's heart is about to kick in momentarily. And Era is still on the run. He does have time lapse. His Lincoln Sphere is also up and ready. So S4 charges. That's going to break the Lincoln Sphere. In fact, does. And Era should survive by just Yakuuching back home.
Yeah, see you guys later. I'm going to go punch these creeps in the mid lane here. Not quite farmed enough.
No, I don't think so.
No. But, yeah, it was a good effort. I think they had to make some sort of a play like that and try and get everyone on top of the Spectre. Like, if they just make it to your base as 5, I don't think there's any way you win that fight anyway, right? So, gotta try something. He's gonna get Clarity flown out to him, looks like, or... Yeah, it's on the Courier. Buys a Mango, too. Damn.
That mana. Radiant's middle tower is under attack. Yeah, so, they did use the mana burn for No-Tail. He's still fine.
Cinder and dead?
He very well might be. Yeah, I think
looking
if they...
quite dead.
Yeah, I don't see him surviving this.
Actually, if he...
Oh,
all right, there we go. Great
now
TP.
You can TP.
Go.
Except that this is happening to you. You're
I mean,
getting charged by S4.
The
yeah, there's nothing else to get you there. It's just he played it the best he possibly could. Now they're going to find the Weaver who has to actually time-lapse out. Still taking plenty of damage. Low half health right now. No till will TP home.
Venno just pings the pit like, hey guys, you want to go Roche? I'm good.
Oh, Koifa's found Jerax. He's healing up with the Nature's Attendance. The Zeus Salt, not dead yet. Fire Remnant, and he just leaves.
Oh, there's Zeus Salt down. It was a scouting out. It's cool.
I mean, I don't... Oh man, poor Koifa. He just can't
All
quite
right.
bring
well,
down
Well, there
Jerax
he is.
Down.
There's the Blink Dagger. Now we That's can build nice. Damage. It's time, guys. They've done it. They haven't lost the Rax, and he built Lincoln's and Blink. That's pretty sick. Gotta give them some credit for that one.
Mm-hmm.
Rapier time, right? Let's go.
Maybe not quite Rapier time yet. We'll get there soon.
Probably Daedalus. Even that's just gonna be not that crazy.
I'll head into the pit, no tail, be first in, and they will take this rather quickly.
Hawks there. Stolen by Jax, nicely done.
Escaper not putting themselves in a position even to remotely try to defend this. Oh, Ana's found Koifa. Blink. RP. There it is. They need to find a charge to follow up. Now the Nether Strike. He gets it off in time. They had to break that Lincoln Sphere. Koifa dead for 75 seconds with a nice setup. No tail finds that kill actually with I believe the Haunt that came through.
Nicely and set up.
Back in the Roche we go.
Everyone's getting stacked on the Dire side.
Yeah, like, they have a 20,000 network lead at 35 minutes, so.
Oh,
this
the banana taunt comes out.
Pretty good. Alright. And Era top lane almost has the Desolator finally. Getting first item, Linked Sphere. Falling a bit behind. They still can't really take a fight 5-on-5. They do have Koifa doing a pretty good job pushing when he is alive.
When he's alive, yeah.
Yeah, when he's not getting ganked by RP, you know, when he's... It's very important.
Yeah, it's quite.
I'm just trying to find the good in this game for Escape right now.
You're a good lad.
Because I don't... There's not many positives to look at here. They've lost just about every fight they've been in recently. No-Tail seems to be an unstoppable juggernaut at this point. He has an Aegis now on top of all of his other items, including Heart and his newly completed Diffusal 2. They just have to keep split pushing, and Koifa is the really only person doing that. Era's trying to attempt to.
And as Koifa comes back up, RP will be here in 10 more seconds. We'll see if they just want to try and camp him again on one of these side lanes.
They're gonna make a move sooner rather than later for OG, I would imagine.
Lincoln's on Ana.
For Ana. That's,
no mercy, dude.
Yeah. Well, he's probably fine.
They have, oh man, it's rough. They have like nothing to break it to. Like, I mean, I assume Dazzle's not going to be in range to do poison touch, so pretty much comes down to Kezu just doing some good micro with his boar or Zeus getting the lightning bolt
Cinderin
on top.
Also has a 4-staff too, which is a bit better, I guess, but.
I suppose, yeah. So, yeah, just Kezu's going to be very cautious as to where that's going out. And, well, when you have a Vanguard, Might as well turn that bad boy into an Abyssal eventually, so there's our Basher.
Hey, he's close. Pushing top all by his lonesome air is going to come in and throw. this is not a man fight.
Just a stand there.
Maybe with some help, but even then.
Yeah, take that Shadow Wave.
No-Tail is not... He's not really concerned at all. I do not blame him at this point. No-Tail sitting up for like you talked about. They're going to use him. He's going rather deep. Ana is, like, setting up. The charges on Yaps are on top of that. They might know that he's coming. I'll cancel the charge, but they're all sitting around outside this Radiant base. They're getting ready for the push. Quakeclaw is cutting the creep wave. They only have one creep wave left now in this top lane if they want to go for something here. There's one pushing in bottom lane, too.
Yeah, he can cut mid, too, so this is nice to play by him.
No-Tail
has a safety remnant just in case.
Yeah, No-Tail's just going to work, though. The glyph is going to come out. There's the veil up. Yaptor will do his best, his damnedest, to throw out arc lightnings and lightning bolts to keep No-Tail back.
I can barely clear these waves even with a veil.
There is the creep wave gone, and No-Tail is... You thought about it for a second with the Spectral Dagger up. Shadowblade for Kezu. He wants to try to initiate. S-Force charge again. Good force staff, but it might not be enough. The roar will come through onto Spirit Breaker, but he should still find the Absor here after Meggrave is gone. In fact, will. No-Tail's going to come next. He's looking for Kezu. Gets the bash as well. They will lose the Dire Courier. Meanwhile, Quake for Remnant back into the base. RP comes out. He'll find Era. Is it enough? Absolutely. Buyback is ready. He's going to have to use it. Ana taking a poison touch, blocked by the Lincoln Spear, and they're going back to work on this top range or top set of racks. And the unfortunate thing is they don't have a creep wave, so it's backdoor protected. At least it was for a moment.
This was like the best case scenario. They fully cut the waves, and still, like, they baited them into the base to the fountain, and they still can't kill them.
Yeah, they're just saying, let's all focus on one building. There is a creep wave coming, though, finally, and now the backdoor protection is gone. 3 versus 5. No-Tail still has that Aegis's Abyssal Blade is up.
Hearts kicked in. 197 regen.
Flight of Fist does some nice damage to Jerax, but that's it. They still have Poison Nova, by the way. So that's available to them. And it just looks like OG are just... They're bullying Escape to a victory here. Koifa has been spotted. And they'll find his Skewer back, but he's able to Remnant forward. Another disable, and they'll be able to find the kill. Meanwhile, No-Tail is just killing people in the base on his own.
Shadow Blade on Kezu.
Roar is back up in 2 seconds. Diffusal Blade, will he get it off in time? No, he will not. Godlike Spree for No-Tail. Cinder will be the next to fall, except for the fact that he gets the Grave off in time. Might still go down to Ana with a Shockwave. No, we'll stay alive. But there's the Poison Nova. Era will take it to the face. So too will Koi, but now he's going to get caught out with a Bash. Still, No-Tail is going to work on the racks while this is all
that
happening.
Impetus.
All the charge, he gets the kill. S4 completes the job. Trax is gone mid, 4 is dead, and this
That's
is
it.
Almost certainly the series for OG. They will take it 2-1 against Escape Gaming in 40 minutes in game number 3.
Well, No-Tail kind of stole the show on the Spectre. It was a great pick, but I think Ana, like, played fantastic this game.
Yeah.
There were so many times where I just felt like we were like, goddamn, Ana Dota, like, always in the right spot. Good job picking up Koifa, good item choices with the Shadow Blade. See, so many, like, Split Push is just getting caught out by that item lately where you know, obviously you can react to Blink Dagger in time for a lot of heroes, but comes that Shadow Blade, you know, if you can't give up a slot for a gem, you can't even end up split pushing. So very well played here by OG.